Hey there guys, Hydra here, welcome back to Dragon's Dogma. We started with this orange F-road, huge lump of meat, and we are continuing the game where we left last time. So yeah, like I said on last episode as well, there's a lot of secrets in the game. Hidden chests, hidden stuff, hidden... Come on, break stupid crates. Thank you. And in crates, there's also items. There is a chest over here, which has a hemp. You can combine items, like pretty much everything can be combined. Hello there, little dude. What do you guys have over here? Destroy! There you go. I'm used to actually gathering everything I see. But just for you guys, I won't do that. Like I'm doing right now. I'll stop that right away. And we are going mainly doing, well, pretty much quests, story mode, leveling. And we'll be not be focusing on gathering because the items, I don't really use them normally. So yeah, you know, we can just do whatever we want. So what's over there? We need to go over here. Hello. Is the camera okay? I think this is better. So yeah, there we go, there's a rift, and I'm like, oh my god. And there is Mr. Rook, I think his name is. He has a weird mustache. There you go. He's some kind of a mage, and he is a pawn, which is pretty much a mindless person. And he has the same scar in his hand palm as I have on my heart. So there's the Pawn Legion, and they are pretty much mercenaries, myrmidons. Alright. Yes. Okay. Alright. So I'm just going to skip all the tutorial thingies because I know everything already, pretty much. Hello. Sir? You're coming with me? Yes, let's go. Let's go outside. So yeah, the game is a bit of a combination of Shadow of the Colossus, but also a bit of Dark Souls, where you have unforgiving enemies that just one-hit you, and you go like, oh snap. And they aren't really strategically placed save points. Mr. Rabbit. Grab. This is one hell of a rabbit. Running. Rah! Die, rabbit. No, not Reynard. Let's save Reynard. Let's throw rocks at them. No. We don't need that. We can just throw rocks. There you go, bitch. So yeah, I have a mage with me now, and he is pretty powerful actually, so it's good to have him with me. Yes! So mages, or at least the buff ones, can empower weapons with fire or any elemental. Rift, okay, yes, that's fine, alright, yes, cool, hello. I got a leather cape from him. That's cool. Let me go to equipment. We are going down. Leather cape. Equip. There you go. That looks better. Way better. Nice. I like it. So what I'm going to do, okay, is a lot of saving every now and then, because if I die now, I gotta go all the way back before we even left town. So I gotta save that dude again, and you know, rabbit pelt. I want that. Give me the rabbit pelt. Thank you. Alright. So there we go. There is still the freaking annoying pawns that are talking. Just that don't make sense every now and then. Normally I just go explore the entire area, but for now we're just going to focus on the storyline. There should be a quest over there, or a chest, not a quest. Go. Open the chest. Go. Do it. No? I'll do it myself then. Screw you. That's another 1k gold. That's cool. I hope my camera isn't in the way though. If rooks would just shut up, then we can listen to the voice. Whoopsie. Well, that's a faster way of tearing down a building. Just slap a explosive barrel with your sword. Nothing over here. Sorry. And that's a riftstone there. That's pretty much the place where you summon the pawns. So we can just go over there. Hello. Yes, I can. Nice. Lego. You are important. Ah, Mercedes, that's true. Oh nice, so we have emblems on the map now where we can actually talk to... Yeah. Nice. Let's get items and deposit stuff. Like, we don't need a lot of this and it's just going to tire me. Fisherman tatters. You can keep that as well. I'm only going to keep the health things. Cures torpor, cures poison. We don't really need that at the moment. Later in game, yes. But not right now. Learn our set skills. Let's learn some skills. Broadcut, scourge. Oh, we don't have enough experience. So, just as a thing, this is where you can learn skills. There's sword skills, shield skills, because I'm a fighter, so I have a sword and a shield. And there's core skills, which just count, I think, for all the warrior things. Augments for, well, augments for the class itself, and secret augments. That's new. And interesting as well. All right. Nice, nice, nice. That's cool. So we're just going to run outside, and then something is going to happen. Spoilers, it's a Cyclops. Whoops. Yeah, like I said, I'm not going to keep anything a secret. Yeah, just until the moment is there. So this is the first... Nah, it's not the first. It's pretty much the second after the Manticore. Tum 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 tum. Cyclops. So the thing with these things is that they have tusks, and if you want their tusks, you need to climb in there and chop them off, or have a mage with a fireball cast it in his face. Ooh, they look a bit cooler now though. Their eyes used to be a lot bigger, so let's just save up here. Come on. You cannot... Oh, we're in combat. Cool. Alrighty then. But these things hit very hard. Let's just climb his ass. Hello, excuse me, excuse me. I'm go. Can I? Please. Fuck's sake. This is freaking annoying me. I cannot climb anything because he doesn't keep still. And now, yeah, alright, that's cool. Never mind then. So there's not really a spot where you can climb up on his. Can you please chill the hell out? It's close to dying already, though, so it's not that. Oh, crap. Oh, crap. Jesus. Wow. Right, let me just get rid of the on the controls. Just get used to it. Why? Oh, wait. Left bumper is shield. Sorry. Come out of here, piece of shit. Link's right. Dude. Oh, then why are you on his face? Alright, let's just climb in his arm. That's cool. Hello. Hello, let me just... Yeah, that could be. But how about I just climb on his face? How about that? Hello, face. How's your eye doing? I hope it's good. Oh, wait. That hurt. Right, I'm still a bit clumsy. I gotta say that. No, Rook! Thank you. Ow. Fuck. Stand up. So this is some kind of a healing aura, where you just have to stand in to get healed. But every time you get a hit, your maximum HP goes down. So, yeah, you need to either fill that up with food or with something else. Do I want to stand? He's standing in the fire. That's cool. Let me just climb you then. Come on. Come on. Then do that, Rook. Show him off balance. Bonk. Alright. Let's go. Is it that easy? That's cool. Now slap his face. He dead. Right, so playing melee in the game is, in my opinion, is the hardest thing you can actually do, because the mages are really strong and it's easy to stay a range of Cyclops. Oh, that's Mr. Bad Guy, by the way. He's still ugly and scary as fuck. Yeah, we got this. Let's first loot, because these things drop pretty specific items only for them to drop, I think. Or maybe that's different now. Like the tusk themselves, if you can break it, you can actually use it and, well, craft stuff with it. You can only get those items from a Cyclops or from a Manticore or from a whatever. Speak of them to rest of them. I don't need that. Just going over there. Examine. Thank you. I'm the most clumsiest warrior at the moment. Yeah. Talk faster. So now I'm going to create a second character, and that's going to be my sidekick. Yeah. And I'm going to make him just as buffed as I am right now. So I'm going to make these two giant warrior type guys, which are just going to slay anything they see. Let's see. My pawn used to be Mr. Slave. But yeah, you know. Let's just call him Barry for now. Or I can call him Mr. Framer. Let's call him Mr. Framer. Mr. Framer. And the moniker, yeah, with parental controls, whatever. He's going to be a Hamilton as well. Because I can. Mr. Framer Hamilton. Don't care. So Mr. Framer is going to be a big lump of meat, like I said, as well. So we're going to take this build. Test. Yes! He's going to get a childish voice. He's going to sound amazing. Yeah, cool. I'm going to make a very old man out of him. He's going to be my veteran, my war leader, my commander. Alright, Alzheimer. Is this how you want to go? He's going to look a bit like Gandalf, I think. Oh, this looks old. Dreadlocks would be cool as well. Okay, this is female hair. Can we get him an afro as well? No, that's going to be too much. Too much afro.
Yo, I'm going to give him this hairstyle, face shape. Yes. I think. This one, let's go. Eyes are fine, brows, blah, 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 that's all looking fine. Come on. Edit body. Preset. No, never mind. Stature. Weight. Tall or height tall. Is he going to be a fat grandpa or is he going to be a very slim and agile? He's going to be very slim and agile. His skin could be pink or green. Or like this. Or entirely black. Yes. Can I get him even like literally entirely black in a non-racist way? Yes, this dude is going to look so weird. But I like it. Bulky. Perfect. Alright, let's just take a look at how muscular we can create this guy. Again, going to make this biggest arms again. Going to look a bit like my main. He also didn't skip leg day this time. And the stance is going to be very imposing as well, because he is an awesome old timer. Ooh, looks a bit ladylike. No, macho. There you are. Yeah. All the frickin' scars. Are these red scars? Okay. This one is a trained dragon slayer as well. This one looks good. Wrinkles, yes, that's some great wrinkles you got there. I want a, looks weird like this. He really needs a frickin' beard. What's the biggest beard they got? This one. Which one do I have? I have this one, yeah. There you are. Looks cool. Makeup, how about no? And color adjustments. Is there even whiter hair? Like white. Yeah, that's cool. Makeup, no. And eye color, there's not really any eyes because he has his eyes closed. But if he opens his eyes, they are red. That's how I want my old man to be. A few expressions.
Steel yourself for combat. Steel yourself for combat.
Duh. He looks so intelligently.
Steel yourself for combat.
Alright, this is how a real man looks like. No, the other thing continue. This dude is looking amazing. Oh, now we have a few questions as well, where you can actually define how the dude itself acts in heat of battle. When faced with danger, which trait would you most value in a follower? An iron will, quick thinking, careful preparation, or the charisma to lead others? No, I will be the leader in this group. So you only have to have an iron will. While in battle, which strategy would you prefer your follower employ? Rescue combat, strike at the strongest foes, call for reinforcements, or kill all enemies. This one is going to look at a golem or a griffin and he's going to think, you're going down, son. That's what this dude's going to do. Your follower rescues your party and turns the tide of the entire battle. But what do you have them say? This way, master, leave them to me. No, master, quickly after them. Leave them to me. As a ruler, which gift would you please them? Would please you the most? A magic potion that preserves youth? He would use that, I think. You know, he looks amazing like this. A brave and just hero to succeed you? The perfect spouse? No, no, never. A majestic white steed. How about this one? A brave and just hero to succeed you? And as you can see in the middle, You have like Scatter, Medica, Mitigator, Challenger, all the things that you are actually creating, or which attitude he's going to have. And he's going to have the most of a Challenger and a Scather. Scatter, I don't know what that is. There you go. And he is going to be... I could also make him a mage like this. No, I want to give him, for now, a fighter, because you can always change it. That's a good thing about this game. You can get all the classes to, well, tier 10, and there's also a character level, and, well, you can switch them whenever you want, so you can just completely change your party composition whenever you feel like it, whenever you have a Rift Stone available, or what's this stone called?
What's up? It's Gramps. I'm here.
Oh my god, it's an old man. He looks pathetic, I like it.
Arisen. Nice.
I like that idea. Yeah, pawns can also completely get obliterated, where they get eaten or where they just get thrown off cliffs. And if it's not your sidekick pawn, then you have to get another one. So it's not respawning until you get to a Riftstone. That can be a bit harsh though. Ta-da-da! All right. In addition to the main play, Mario up to two pawns in supporting your adventures. Different pawns have different strengths. Cool. Yes. So now my idea is the other two pawns to become a healer and a spellcaster. I'm not going to have any thieves or archers in my party. So what you're going to do is talk with the stone and then you come into the rift. And this is where, that's Rook, and I want you, go away. And I'm going to look for, Ultra is playing the game at the moment as well. So I'm going to look if I can take his pawn with us, because it might be experienced already. Examine. Search. Friend list. There you go. Pawn can be determined by status. Nice. Choose a pawn to summon. So I'm going to take... This pawn is already in the rift. Oh, they are in here already. Where are they? So this is Sledget, which is level 29 already. Oh my god. That dude is addicted. A few details. What have you got for me? So here you can actually see stats. It's already ranked 10. Oh my Jesus. Ultra has been playing a lot. This chick is overpowered. High Anodyne is a heal. Fire Affinity is fire on your weapons. And then there's High Halidom. Clears all drenching, tarring, petrifications, and lowered attributes. Nice. Then we have Holy Affinity, a holy boon that augments. Okay, that's holy on your weapon, and High Spell Screen is a defense. Nice. I want you to join me. Yes. So this chick is going to boost me a lot. And where is Tuka? There's Tuka. This is the pawn of one of my friends of Final Fantasy, I think. So we're just going to take this with us as well, because it's a level 21. I don't really need a spellcaster if I can get a 21 for free. So here we go. 100 Kisses, Implicate, Splinter Dart, Panted Shot, and Mighty Bend. Those are all really cool skills, really good ones as well. Switch in this pawn for frickin'... No. Oh, for frickin' Rook. We don't need a level 6 in our party. Yes, thank you. No. They will not cross again, Rook, because you suck. So there we go. Exit the frickin' rift. So now we have two overpowered characters with us. The point is, though, that they don't level if they come with us. So if these guys think or decide to stop playing the game at all, then they will get stuck on level 29 and 21. And once I get over 30, then that's not really, you know. Yeah. Should you wish it? I do not want to do that. So goodbye. This is pretty much a tutorial thing. I'm not going to do that. If I can... Oh, I think I have to. Or don't I? Nope. It's pretty much a quick guide to slay some dummies, slay some totems, slay some practice things to actually get used to the pawn system. All right, Mr. Framer, Slasher, and Tuca, let's go. Listen to Mr. Framer, he's so cool. Beep, 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 beep. He sounds like a freaking Smurf.
Okay. I do. Yes. And the AI doesn't really help in that matter. It does not matter. No, you don't want fishwives in here. They can only scream. Let's rest up. And now there's another big mythical creature waiting for us. And not even outside the gate, but I think he's already inside. And it's pretty much my cousin. It's a Hydra. And he's going down. But in this game, a Hydra, I tend to believe that a Hydra actually has paws as well. So it's pretty much a walking creature. But in this game, it's a snake. And I've seen both variants in mythical stories. Mythical. I should stop saying mythical. It's mythological. Come on. Get your facts straight, Hydra. Alright, there we go. So this is a Hydra. I'm going to slap you in the face. Slap you in the face. Slap you in the face. Slap you, slap you. Oh, I think that Ultra also gave his character a really high-pitched voice. Yes. On my way, Master. Where am I going? Okay, I'm just going to climb up a bit more. Oh, this is not going to look good. This is not going the way I want it to go. Not the tower! It's a four-headed snake. Okay. Let's get the tail. Oh, I cannot hit the tail because the tail is too strong. Oh, I'm sorry about that. Sometimes you gotta sneeze, you know? Framer! No. No, no, no. Oh, dear. I gotta get out of there, I think. Can I get out of there? Yes. Thank you. I'm out of here. Stop doing that! They can actually swallow you and then you die, so I just gotta... Thank you. Get out of there. How about you eat one of those? How about you eat one of these? There you go. How about that? How about I get you another barrel? Wait, let me grab... Freaking grab the barrel, you doofus. Excuse me! I have a barrel. Thank you. Alright, let's get another barrel. Oh, there's another barrel over here. Excuse me, sir. Don't do that. Have a barrel. Okay, climb on that. Climb on that. Thank you. Uh-oh. No! In the face. I call this collateral damage. Slap his back. Bash his face in. Bash his face in! I cannot get through the face though. Come on, Sledger. Give me some holy bone. There you go. We're doing perfect. Let's climb up a bit more. Oh no, wait. Weehoo! Riding a freaking Hydra like a boss. Alright, alright. That's one head. What just... Alright, so this actually went really good. Normally there's another part of battling this boss, but I think because of Sledger and Tuca, yeah, we did a lot of damage on his face. So the third part of this encounter is not coming. And normally that's her rolling a barrel towards you, like, use this, it's cool. And then you just gotta make it swallow the thing and then it gotta explode and it's a bit harsh. And here I am in my cloth with my Smurf grandpa.
Just call him Grand Smurf, I think. I should have called him that. Oh, yes, yes. Great. Great stuff. Yeah, good judgment. Impressive, truly. Yeah. Yes, he does. And the Duke is a douchebag. Let's not call him the Duke, let's call him the douche. What's with my head? Let's... Yeah, accept this. So this thing is going on a cart and we're going to go on a travel to the biggest city in the game, I think. If I recall right. Getting the head. Nice. Alright, so you guys are pretty OP. I like it. Regroup with Sir Mercedes. What's up? Thank you. Yeah, this is typically Ultra. Giving them a high-pitched voice just like I did. Sounds so weird. These two are just completely passive on helium, I think. Yes, cool. So we're going to end the episode here. Killing a Hydra, killing a Cyclops. Pretty good stuff. So from here on out, this is where the game really starts and gets a boost and is so much fun to play. Can we get extra quests over here? We can. Ruffled Feathers, kill 2 Seabirds, kill 7 Phantasms, kill 45 Undead Warriors, 8 Spiders, 3 Cyclopses, and 10 Wolves. So this is pretty much just a few side quests which you can do. See them as bounties or kill orders or whatever. So yeah, for now, thank you for watching. I hope to see you on the next adventure. And for now, yeah, bye.